Sorry I'm late.
Oh, it's okay.
She'll never guess who I saw standing out there.
Who?
Barbara.
Oh my goodness, I haven't seen that lady since high school.
Oh, geez, she's aged. She looks like an old hag.
I believe it.
But honestly, did you hear what happened to her?
No.
Last night, they hired a plumber to come out and look at their pipes because they're having problems with their toilets. This morning, they found her dead in the basement.
Oh my lord.
Can you believe that? I told my husband that this place was bad news. This neighborhood is awful. I mean, security, everything. It's just terrible.
I don't know. I wouldn't blame it on the neighborhood. I'd blame it on her husband. That guy was a jerk.
He was kind of weird. Yeah, he was pretty strange. I honestly never would step within 10 feet of that man.
I know.
Your drinks, please?
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Are you okay? A man died in our house last night, Fred. How am I supposed to feel?
Don't worry about it. I mean, the police are covering this, and everything's gonna be okay.
Wait till I...
Question.
What is it, Betty Sue?
How come when you were in the house all alone with the plumber, he died? Then when you were in the house all alone with Daddy, he died.
Are you accusing me of something, Betty Sue?
Oh, certainly not. No fine American who voted for George Bush would ever do something like that.
I know. Now, personally, I am glad that we have a man like George Bush in a position of power in the United States of America.
Amen to that, Mother.
Adam.
Hello, I am Al Gore. I single-handedly murdered all of these fine Americans in this here fail. I murdered the plumber, the mother, the father, and even here Betty Sue. I will take this time to talk about George Bush, who is now a president. You see, he is a president because of Republicans. These Republicans right here are the reason me, Al Gore, is not the president. I single-handedly murdered each one of these fine Americans with this here knife. The reason I murder them is because they are Republicans. And you know what happens to Republicans? They die. All Republicans will die until Al Gore is elected president. I will take this time to talk about election issues. My medical plan will cover all Americans, while my opponent's plan, George W. Bush, will not cover all Americans. Some Americans' houses will be burnt down to the ground, and that is just not right. You see, if you don't elect Al Gore Vice President of the United States as your future president, more Republicans will sadly be murdered by me, Al Gore. I will leave you now with a word of advice. Don't be a Republican. Then you know what happens to Republicans. Republicans die.
Imagine laying new, I do. I think about you day and night. It's only to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me, imagine how the world could be. So very fine, so happy together. Toss the dice, it had to be. The only one for me is you, and you for me. So happy together.
What are you watching? This is crap. What are you watching? Give me your remote.
Give back!
Give me your remote.
Back. Give back! No!
Man, turn this all off.
Man, no! No!
Yo, man, calm down. What you doing?
I don't want to watch that show. That's not a good show. I'm not watching Survivor.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
You won't let me watch.
You want to watch Survivor? Come on. I mean, Survivor? Of all shows?
I know how you guys can work this out. You guys both want to watch your own TV shows, right?
Yeah, I want to watch the Shopping Network.
No, you don't.
So why don't you guys battle it out like they do on Survivor? And whoever is an ultimate champion gets to be king of the remote.
Good idea. Is that a good idea?
Who is the ultimate survivor?
Three participants. All fighting for all they can to get the ultimate goal. Control. The remote.
Yo, dog, it's hard in this joint. That's insane, man.
I will be the ultimate survivor. The remote is mine.
Can't get enough pretzels.
Whoa.
Living room.
My pretzels.
Yes, I want some pretzels.
Don't take my pretzels. No, please, don't take my pretzels. My pretzels. Please don't take pretzels.
Me too.
Georgie, what are you doing?
Please
don't take my pretzels.
What are you doing with the paper?
Pretzels, don't take pretzels.
No, what's wrong with you guys? No?
My pretzels!
I really wish a pretzel boy would share his pretzels. This paper doesn't taste very good. And that little small boy who acts like he is African American is very annoying.
I mean, God, he's like, oh, Survivor, I'm gonna hum the song. What's up with this? God, I can't stand him. He's gonna go crazy on us or something.
I don't like when people steal my pretzels. They've been stealing them ever since I got here. At least it seems like it. How's this? It's already half empty, and there's not enough for me to eat for the next... Until I get the remote, and I will get the remote. I will. I'm going to be the remote champion of all remotes, so I don't have to watch that show Survivor anymore. Because that kid, Georgie, he scares me with his little Survivor sayings and
that... Gins in the living room.
Excuse me, Mr. Pretzel Boy.
These pretzels will hit my head that you hit earlier. There's no reason for that violence.
I really wish you were.
I like pretzels.
I really wish you were. The survivor. Ow! My hurting thumb! Ow!
Because today starts a new day. We're going to have challenges today, the first one of many. And that's going to be lifting weights. Survivors ready?
Ready.
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 And their survivor is...
It's okay, Pretzel Boy.
Poser! The champion.
Yo, I knew I could win a challenge. I mean, Sergeant G's over here can't lift a thing. I'm gonna win. I'm gonna win that remote, and I'm gonna watch anything I want. Not Survivor.
Georgie's better than you!
Ow! Georgie's not very strong, but he's very smart. And you know, fakey African American boy over there, just you know a thing. And Pretzel Boy is just a dumbass. I said a bad word. I gotta go with prize mouth.
I like pretzels. I like them a lot. Resist the temptation at the end of the match, and I just fell. But I was still strong, and I'm still going to win. Remote.
Arise in the living room. It's time to go upstairs to the dining room to figure out who's the first survivor to leave the island. These pine cones symbolize life in the living room. One will not remain at the end of the tribal council.
Georgie doesn't like pine cones.
No.
Yeah.
He's gonna hurt you.
You broke the survivor sign.
The time has come for the members of the living room to cast their votes to see who they want to be gone.
Gerald, is anyone in there? I am voting off Pretzel Boy because he won't share his pretzels. And he is very mean because I do not like...
I'm right here. I can hear you.
I do not like the African-American wannabe boy much either, but he is immune. Whatever that means, I don't know. But right now, Pretzel Boy dies. Thank you, and have a nice day.
I'm voting off Georgie.
He's still here.
I don't like him. Don't like him at all. He's very mean to me, very mean. Just because I like pretzels so much that I like pretzels, okay? And I don't like him.
Time of truth. Who will be kicked out of the living room? The first vote is for Pretzel Boy.
I won the remote. I won the remote. Well.
The next vote, Georgie.
Oh, no, me, I hate when this happens. I'm always losing it. Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
I did that vote. Those are you because I don't like you.
The third vote.
You know, I don't like that lady either.
Is.
She is ugly. And mean.
What?
I can't read this.
So, what? It's just staying kindergarten. But it's Pretzel Boy.
You're right.
I told you to share my pretzels, and you wouldn't see your pretzels, but now you're gone.
Not too friendly of you to kick me off.
Yeah,
I hate them all by myself.
The remaining two, Poser and Georgie, return victorious back to the living room.
Yay, what's that? I got my pine cones still.
Excuse me, I don't like these pine cones. Can we get a new toy?
I may have lost my courage and my self-confidence in the whole remote challenge, but at heart, I got nothing. Well, I do got my pretzels. I had my pretzels and all this food, and I'd rather eat pretzels any day than watch stupid TV. And to Poser and Georgie, I hope they both lose by some default or something like that. I have all the food I can eat.
With only two survivors left, it's time for the last immunity challenge. This one is the game of intellect. So let the games begin. All right, I'm going to be asking you questions about the first season of Survivor. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Question one. Who got liposuction after leaving the island?
Dead Bill Clinton. Yeah, what now?
Beep. Sorry.
That is Richard Hatch.
Richard Hatch. That's
Richard
right.
Richard Hatch?
Is that a poser?
So, Georgie has one, and Poser has nothing. Yeah. You still have a chance to catch up. Time for question two. Which survivor has a tattoo on their back?
Will Smith.
Sorry.
He's so gay.
I think that was wrong.
Feet.
Yep.
It's Kelly.
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 Very good. Georgie has two. Poser has nothing. Question three. Who on the island was also a sweet mother. Also a survivor and also a doctor.
That would be...
Oh,
completely different people together to watch one.
Hi, Mommy. Is anyone in there? Hi. Hi. Can I see food?
Georgie won, you know, but I was awarded with lots of very scrumptious food, and as you can see, I got this refilled because you can never get enough pretzels, right? Now, anyways, want to know a secret? I don't really hate Georgie. I just don't want him to take my pretzels.
I thought they all played fair. And I'm proud of each and every one of them. Especially Georgie.
Go, Georgie!
on all day anyway.
Hey, it's all right. Come on. We'll get to a Blockbuster tonight or some anime, you know, have a little fun.
Sounds good.
And can we take Earth with us? Oh, yes, we can. But first, I have to go to bed.
Oh, completely understood.
I'll be right back.
We'll be here.
Don't start without me.
Oh, sure.
Did they leave without me already? I didn't know we were going to Blockbuster now. The Book of the Hakusho. And now, as the journey begins, the two gens enter a world that very few anime fans have ever been to before. Reality?
Jenna, where are we?
I have no idea. Why do I have double deep breaths?
And why do I feel like kicking your butt like we're in a fighting game?
No. Let's go.
Get ready. Fight!
Oh my god. Why am I wearing sticks and shields? I can't wear sticks and shields.
Yes, the gens were cursed to relive the worst moments of every manga, anime, or Japanese import video game ever. This was brought upon them by their great love of a foreign culture. This is really weird.
And you don't seem to understand. Does this make any sense? Wait a minute, what this?
girl does in her spare time. She... this thing. What? It beeps. Oh god. Someone's in trouble. What should I do? No. Pen.
Has made an important discovery.
Only by naming the animators that they are trapped within may they release themselves from this curse they have brought upon themselves. Their next challenge lies ahead.
Jenna, I'm sorry that while we were on our mission, I accidentally stabbed you with this here sword. It's your blood that I shed, and it's my responsibility to heal you. Now it's my turn to go on a quest to try and find the antidote to your ailment. Goodbye, my love.
Do you know what?
Watch.
If Serge wore a trench coat, you'd be so much sexier.
Yes, I agree. I am much more sexier than Serge from Chrono Cross. Goodbye.
Solve that riddle. So, I wonder, why am I still here? Oh my god! Akira! Oh my god, this is Akira. Oh my god.
Ha! I am Hello Kitty. I am the one who brought you here. Now, you have proven yourself true otaku. You win many great prizes.
Really?
How? Ha! Would you? You just go home. And as the great cat had said, the two gens had proven themselves to be the true otaku of their generation. Now, at last, they were allowed to return home. And so ended a fantastic journey that may have changed the team, for better or for worse, but had certainly given them a taste of something they had never seen before.
That's a good story. But where are Jen and Jenna? Hey! Hey, guys! Jen? Jenna? Where were you two?
Oh my god.
Jenna?
Our boobs are back!
Oh my god!
They're real!
You would have never believed what just happened to us. It was insane. It was like a nasty dream.
Yeah, like, we had to go through every single anime there was.
You're kidding me. You guys went inside an anime?
I never want to look at something like this again in my life.
Good riddance.